Hello, 8th standard student. In the last session, we have studied about how we can solve the different sums by using the properties of parallelogram, trapezium, kites and other different kinds. And now in this session, we are going to study the different properties of different quadrilaterals. Now look at here, the first quadrilateral is parallelogram. Okay, you have to write these properties and definition in your notebook. So by using the key of pause of stopping of this video, you can write these properties and definition in your notebook, and you have to write it because it is very important to solve the exercise 3.4, which is our last exercise of this topic. So the first quadrilateral is parallelogram. A quadrilateral with each pair of opposite sides are parallel, and the properties are: opposite sides are equal, opposite angles are equal, diagonals are bisect one another. The second is rhombus. A parallelogram with sides of equal length is known as rhombus. All the properties of parallelogram, that means opposite sides are equal in length, opposite angles are equal in length, diagonals are bisect one another, but while bisecting each other, they are perpendicular to each other, that means while intersecting with each other, they forming 90 degree angle. The next is rectangle. A parallelogram with a right angle. Now look at here. All the properties of parallelogram, that is opposite sides are equal in length, same in length, opposite sides, these opposite angles are equal in length, opposite diagonals are bisect each other, these diagonals are equal, and each angle of this angle is a right angle triangle, right angle. Dear students, we already have studied about the rectangle. We know that a rectangle having all angles are 90 degree and opposite angles each other and diagonals are equal. And already we have using this Pythagoras theorem while solving the sums on rectangle. The next one is square. A rectangle with sides of equal length. So, as like the parallelogram, rhombus and rectangle, opposite sides are equal, opposite angles are equal, diagonals are equal, they are bisect each other, they are perpendicular each other. The last point is kite. A quadrilateral with exactly two pairs of equal consecutive sides. Look at here, two consecutive. Adjacent sides are different in length, but opposite sides are equal in length. So diagonals are perpendicular to one another, one of the diagonals bisect the other, and in the figure major angle B and major angle D are equal, but major angles C, A and C, which are opposite angles, are not equal in measures. So by using this property, we have to solve the exercise 3.4, and now we are going to solve the exercise 3.4. Look at here carefully. Exercise 3.4. Solution of the question on page number 55. Our school have already shared a link where you can read your textbook. So open your maths textbook, page number 55. Exercise 3.4. The question number first state whether true or false. All rectangles are square. So it is false because all squares are rectangles, but all rectangles are not squares. Because rectangle having opposite sides are equal in length, but square having all sides are equal in length. Second, all rhombus are parallelograms. True, because opposite sides of rhombus are equal and parallel to each other like parallelogram. The C, all squares are rhombus and also rectangles. Of course, true, because all squares are rhombus as all sides of a squares are equal of equal lengths. All squares are also rectangles as each internal angles measures 90 degree. D. All squares are not parallelogram. False. All squares are parallelogram because opposite sides are equal and parallel. E. All kites are rhombus. False. A kite does not have all sides are of same length. Only opposite sides are equal in length. F. All rhombus are kites. True. A rhombus also has two distinct consecutive pairs of sides of equal length. G. All parallelograms are trapezium. True, because all parallelograms have pair of parallel sides as like trapezium. H. All squares are trapezium. True, because as like trapezium, all squares have a pair of parallel sides. Question number 2. Identify all the quadrilaterals that have four sides of equal length and B, four right angle. So, four sides of equal length, that means a rhombus and square. And four or right angles, that is square and right angle. By using the table of properties, you can write these answers. Question number 3. Explain how a square is a quadrilateral, parallelogram, rhombus and rectangle. Okay, the first one. A square is a quadrilateral because square is it has a four side, and quadrilateral that means a closed figure which having four side, four vertices and four angles. Square is a parallelogram because its opposite sides are parallel to each other. Square is a rhombus because its four sides are of same length. And square is a rectangle because its each interior angle is 90 degree. So dear student, you have you realize that how properties are important to solve the example or to recognize the different types of figures. Question number 4. Name the quadrilateral whose diagonals bisect each other, are perpendicular bisector of each other and are equal. Now look at here the answers. The diagonals of parallelogram, rhombus, square and rectangle bisect each other. The diagonals of a rhombus and square act as a perpendicular bisector. And the third one, the diagonals of a rectangle are and square are equal. Question number 5. Explain why a rectangle is a convex quadrilateral. Rectangle is a convex quadrilateral because there are two diagonals both lying interior of the rectangle. Hence, it is a convex quadrilateral because concave quadrilateral shows the one part is moves to the inner side of the figure. And convex quadrilateral means both interior parts lying interior in the quadrilateral. Question number 6. ABC is a right angle triangle and O is the midpoint of the side and opposite to the right angle. Explain why O is equidistant from A, B and C. The dotted lines are drawn additionally to help you. Now we have drawn here line AD, line DC such that AD parallel to BC and side AB parallel to DC. So, AD is equal to BC and AB is equal to DC. So, ABCD is a rectangle as opposite sides are equal and parallel to each other and all the interior angles are 90 degree. In rectangle, diagonals are of equal length and also these bisect each other. So, we can say that OA is equal to OC and OB is equal to OD. So, that is thus O is equidistant from A, B and C. As like that, dear students, you have to solve this exercise 3.4, which is exercise in your notebook, because when school will reopen, I will check it. And if you have any query, you can ask me in the comment box. So, without wasting your time, try to solve this all exercise of topic number 3, that is understanding quadrilateral. Try to listen this carefully video again and again. I know that you are brilliant. You can solve this. You can solve all this exercise. So, without wasting your time, let's start your study. Solve all this exercise in your notebook. Till then, have a good day.